Daily Minutes nummer 1533 met een uitzending voor vandaag, 26 januari 2019. This broadcast will be almost completely in English. De uitzending is bijna helemaal vandaag in het Engels. We beginnen vandaag met het RGB-nieuws. Als data hebben we de uitzending van Shortwave Radiogram, zoals ik die vanmiddag ontvangen heb. Ik schakelde op 9400 kHz iets te laat in, waarbij het leek alsof er geen audio was. Zeker 1 minuut stond er een kale draaggolf, waarbij op een gegeven moment ineens het audio werd opengedraaid. Toevallig was dat net aan het begin van een afbeelding. Omdat de opname geen Reed-Solomon-code bevat, heb ik zelf aan het begin die code toegevoegd. De uitzending is dus afgelopen middag om 1500 uur CET opgenomen op een frequentie van 9400 kHz. Shortwave Radiogram bevat diverse afbeeldingen, alle in FL-Digi te ontvangen. Het begint met MFSK 32. Aanbevolen wordt om de nieuwste versie van FL-Digi te gebruiken, maar met een oudere versie werkt het vast ook wel.
Hello, this is Bob McCready, G0FGX, with the TX Talk podcast of the GB2 RS News from the Radio Society of Great Britain. The news headlines, 3 new bands for Indonesians, listen to an ISS contact, and become an RSGB board member or regional representative. The Indonesian National Society, ORARI, reports new amateur radio regulations have been issued, with top-class licensees gaining new WRC 15 secondary allocations at 136 kHz, 472 kHz and 5 MHz. An International Space Station school contact has been planned between David St. Jacques, Kilo Golf 5, Foxtrot Yankee India, and a school in Portugal. The event is scheduled for Saturday, the 2nd of February, at approximately 15:23 UTC. The conversation will be conducted in English and will be direct contact operated via Charlie Sierra 5, Sierra Sierra. The downlink signals will be audible in many parts of Europe on 145.800 MHz FM. There's just under 1 week left for RSGB members to make nominations for the board and regional representative vacancies. These roles offer a great opportunity to help the RSGB develop and promote amateur radio, and you can find more details on the RSGB website. Please note the nominations close on the 31st of January. Bulgarian amateurs have obtained some important changes to their license. The age limit has been removed for getting a Class 2 license, which permits up to 5 watts on VHF and UHF plus HF on a club station. A Class A license for all bands with full legal power can now be obtained at 14 years of age, and the mandatory 6-month period between the Class 2 and Class 1 exams has also been removed, and there has been a significant increase in the power allowed on most bands. Ian Stewart, Golf Mike 4, Alpha Uniform Papa, has been appointed as the RSGB's first Operating Advisory Service Coordinator. The Operating Advisory Service, OAS, has been established to help amateurs in various ways, especially those whose enjoyment is being hindered by the poor activities of others. These include giving practical guidance to individual members, delivering talks to clubs, and sharing their own OAS experiences with the national OAS team. Working with him is a growing team of regional operating advisors, and the aim is to have at least one advisor in every region assisting the region's volunteer team with OAS developing expertise. Please encourage any suitable candidate in your region to apply for the regional operating advisor role by contacting Ian via email to oas@rsgb.org.uk. oas@rsgb.org.uk. The Inter-MAI amateur radio slow scan television experiment on the International Space Station is expected to be activated between Wednesday the 30th of January and Friday the 1st of February. It appears that the experiment will only be active during a couple of orbits that overfly Moscow rather than a continuous operation. Expected periods of activation appear to be between 1300 and 1900 UTC and should occur on the traditional 145.800 MHz downlink frequency. Next up, we've got the details of rallies and events for the coming week. The Horncastle Amateur Radio and Electronics Rally takes place on Sunday the 27th of January at the Horncastle Youth Centre, Cagthorpe Buildings, Willow Row, Horncastle. So that's this Sunday. And the postcode is Lima November 9, 6 Delta Zulu. Doors open at 10 a.m. and entry is £2. Traders tables are £5 per 6-foot table. There is free parking at the venue and all the usual traders will be there. Catering's available on site and Tony can tell you more. His call sign, Golf 3, Papa Zulu Uniform, and his phone number 01507 527 01507 527 835, and you can email him at tony.nightingale, spelt like the bird, at yahoo.co.uk. On the 3rd of February, the 35th Sears Canvey Radio and Electronics Rally will be held at its new venue, which is the Cornelius Vermeiden School in Dinant Avenue, Canvey Island. The postcode Sierra Sierra 89 Quebec Sierra. Admission is £3 and the doors open at 10 a.m. or 50 minutes earlier for disabled visitors. There is free car parking and easy level ground floor access to two large halls. Tea, coffee, soft drinks and bacon butties will be available, and there will be radio computing and electronics traders and special interest groups. Tony can tell you more, and his email is tony@tonystreet.net. And get your event into Radcom, onto GB2RS and on the RSGB website. Remember, you need to send the details as early as possible to radcom@rsgb.org.uk. We need to know about 4 months in advance for Radcom. DX News is next from 425 DX News and other sources. ART, November November 7 Alpha, is going to be active as Victor 31 Juliet Zulu portable from Southwater Cay in Belize. IOTA reference November Alpha 180, and that's from the 31st of January to the 6th of February. He will be operating mainly CW on the 80 to 10 meter bands, QSL via Club Logs OQRS, or via November November 7 Alpha, either direct or via the Bureau. Mike, Oscar Echo 3, Mike Bravo Golf will be on the air as Sierra 79 Alpha Alpha in the Seychelles, that's Alpha Foxtrot 024, until the 2nd of February. QSLs of our Club Log, OQRS, and logs will be uploaded to Logbook of the World. Heli Delta Delta Zero Victor Romeo is going to be active as Charlie 6 Alpha / Delta Delta Zero Victor Romeo from the Bahamas, November Alpha 001, and possibly other island groups as well, until the 2nd of February. Usually he operates QRP on the 80 to 10 meter bands using CW and SSB. QSL is via Delta Delta Zero Victor Romeo, direct or via the Bureau. Rick November 8 Zulu is going to be active from Ecuador until the 6th of February. He will be operating CW, SSB and FT8 on the 40 to 6 meter bands. Listen for Hotel Charlie 1 Mike Delta, Hotel Charlie 1 Mike Delta / Hotel Charlie 2 and Hotel Charlie 1 Mike Delta / Hotel Charlie 7, depending on his location. QSL via Logbook of the World or direct to Kilo 8 Lima Juliet Golf. Hotel 1 Lima Tango will be manned by members of the Loma del Toro DX Club until the 28th of January. They'll be located on Beata Island, November Alpha 122. That's off the coast of the Dominican Republic. And the QSL manager for that one, Whiskey 2, Charlie Charlie Whiskey. Emmanuel Foxtrot 5 Lima India Tango is going to be active as Yankee Bravo 9 / Foxtrot 5 Lima India Tango from Bali Island, Ocean Charlie 022. That's from the 27th of January to the 6th of February. QSL via his home call sign, direct only, and Logbook of the World. Now the special event news, and the Worked All Britain Group Golden Anniversary Year got off to a good start with Golf Bravo 50 Whiskey Alpha Bravo starting in Northern Ireland and Golf Bravo 9 Whiskey Alpha Bravo in Leicestershire. Golf Bravo 50 WAB will continue to run throughout the year from various locations. Currently being aired from North Lincolnshire, it moves on to Hereford on the 29th. Other WAB GB special calls will also be run throughout the year, in addition to regular airings of the club's calls, Golf 4 Whiskey Alpha Bravo and Golf 7 Whiskey Alpha Bravo. The month of February will see Golf Bravo 8 Whiskey Alpha Bravo operated by Mike India 1 Alpha India Bravo, and also Golf Bravo 0 Alpha Bravo Golf operated by Golf 4 India Alpha Romeo. Keep an eye out on the Worked All Britain website, which is worked-all-britain.org.uk. That's worked-all-britain.org.uk. The special call sign Echo India 19 Romeo Echo is going to be active for the duration of 2019 to commemorate the establishment of the Dáil, the first Irish Parliament. Please send your special event details to radcom@rsgb.org.uk as early as possible, please, for free publicity on GB2RS in Radcom and online. And remember that UK special event stations must be open to the public so our free publicity can help make your efforts more widely known. Contest news now, and ending its 48-hour run at 2200 UTC Sunday the 27th, the CQ Worldwide 160-meter DX contest uses CW only. The exchange is Signal Report and CQ Zone, which for the UK is Zone 14. In addition, US and Canadian stations send their state or province. Ending its 24-hour run at 1200 UTC Sunday the 27th is the BARTG RTTY Sprint Contest. Using RTTY on the 3.5 to 28 MHz bands, the exchange is simply the serial number. The UK EI Contest Club runs its contest from 2000 to 2100 UTC on Wednesday the 30th of January. This one uses CW only on the 80-meter band, and the exchange is your four-character locator. Next Sunday, the 3rd of February, the 432 2 MHz AFS contest runs from 0900 to 1300 UTC. Using all modes, the exchange's signal report, serial number, and locator. Next, we've got the radio propagation report compiled by Golf 0, Kilo Yankee Alpha, Golf 3, Yankee Lima Alpha, and Golf 4, Bravo Alpha Oscar on Friday the 25th of January. This week, we did get a new sunspot group, which pushed the solar flux index to 71 and the sunspot number to 18, reflecting one group with eight spots on it. But, as predicted last week, incoming matter from a solar coronal hole resulted in an elevated K index and poor HF conditions on Wednesday the 23rd. Because of this, maximum usable frequencies were depressed and struggled to reach much more than 14 MHz at times. Late Wednesday afternoon even saw 40 meters closing early. Despite a continued K-index of 4 on Thursday, MUFs did manage to recover slightly and signals were heard on many HF bands. This included an opening around Europe and out as far as Israel and Cyprus on 10 metres FT8, which may have been due to pre-auroral enhancement. There were other highlights during the week. Andy, Mike Zero, November Kilo Romeo reported working Echo 51 Delta Whiskey Charlie on the South Cook Islands on 20 metres CW on Monday afternoon. That was around about 5:30 in the evening, which just goes to show you shouldn't write the bands off. Next week, NOAA has the solar flux index remaining at 71, with generally quieter geomagnetic conditions at least until Thursday the 31st. This may then herald 3 days of unsettled conditions due to a recurrent coronal hole. As always, don't neglect the upper HF bands, especially at the onset of a geomagnetic storm, as these can often bring short-lived openings on the higher HF frequencies. Next, the VHF and up-propagation news, and it's shaping up to be another rather flat week for Tropo, I'm afraid, although it's always possible to get some limited surface ducting in the early mornings with this cold, frosty weather and patchy fog. Much of the coming week is dominated by low pressure and at times brisk winds, which will rule out traditional Tropo options. That probably leaves, like last week, just a few chances of some rain scatter on the gigahertz bands. Snow, however, does act as a very good scatterer on these bands as well. Keep a watch for the other exotic modes like out-of-season winter sporadic E or some auroral QSOs. What about trying some flat condition path checks to see how your station is doing by calibrating against a selection of beacons or repeaters so that you have a baseline to compare against when the high-pressure systems do return? Incidentally, you could even try a late New Year resolution to activate CW on the VHF and UHF bands. You never know, flat conditions can provide more than you think. Moon declination is negative again and reaches minimum next Saturday. Moon windows will shorten as the week progresses and maximum moon elevation will be in the early morning, so it's a week for EME early risers. We're still in the doldrums as far as meteor showers go, with just a couple of minor ones in February and March until we get to the April Lyrids. And that's it from the propagation team this week. Don't forget, if you want to hear the local amateur radio news for your area, then tune in to the amateur radio station that provides that service for where you live, and you can find out more details about that. And you can also read a full transcript of this news broadcast and the local news broadcast by going to the RSGB website and looking under news. I'm Bob McCready, G0FGX. This has been the TX Talk podcast of the GB2 RS News from the Radio Society of Great Britain.
Daily Minutes zijn dagelijks vanaf ongeveer 1900 uur te beluisteren. De uitzending wordt een dag later om 10:30 ochtends herhaald. Alle mail is welkom op het adres x@xdv.me. Dat is ook te vinden rechts bovenaan de webpagina van de uitzendingen www.pa0ete.nl. De Daily Minutes toont iedere dag weer aan de hand van schokkende voorbeelden hoe een hobby mensenlevens kan veranderen. De internetfaciliteiten en studiohardware voor Daily Minutes worden gesponsord door 70MHzShop.nl. 70MHzShop.nl.
week 6 of Texan Radios Australia's competition. Remember to decode and collect the 6 Texan Radios images transmitted on shortwave radiogram for your chance to win a Texan PL880 radio prize pack worth over $250 Australian dollars. Share all 6 images on Twitter at Texan Radios and send them an email, hello@texanradios.com.au. The winner will be judged on February 1st, 2019. They'll even ship the prize pack anywhere in the world. And now, more information in MFSK 64.
Thank you. naar het toer.